Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how we can use ChatGPT to generate our little cover letter inside PandaDoc so that we can tie this in with the last video that I did where I went through how to set up the line items so that in HubSpot when you have the line items for a deal like this and it will automatically go into PandaDoc and add the line items like this. So this is pretty simple. Basically, this is the zap that I went through in the last video, which you can check out the last video. I don't want to go into detail in that now. I'll link to that video and I strongly advise you to check it out. It's very useful. Basically just goes through explaining that process. And the big thing missing though with this proposal is our cover letter. So everything else has all been sort of standardized, but the cover letter is something that's kind of needs to be unique and somewhat customized. So we can't just, you know, copy paste the template over. So we need to make sure we have the right information. So basically, let's go through this very, very quickly, and I'll just pull through the data that we need. So we have the updated trigger, the trigger step. So when the deal comes through and it's changed to the decision maker bought in, so we get our new data come through like this, we can click continue, and then it's going to grab the associations for this new deal. These are the ID numbers that we then need to search for in HubSpot. We're going to grab the company ID number and the company details. We're going to also extract the first contact. So in this example, there's only one contact, so that part's easy. We'll get the contact detail here. And then we have our loop step. And so we'll grab the detail for the loop. We're going to have two loops, three loops. And then there's the delay step. We can skip that. And then we're going to pull in the line item for the detail for the first line item in the loop. Like this, so we can see here, it's the marketing consultation. So we've got our first line item here, and then we want to append the detail of that line item. Okay, I've got a few tests that already ran here, so this is the third line item with that detail, and then let's get the price. Got our three example prices, then we'll grab our quantity. Here we go, 222. The loop will then stop with this filter step. And then we release the information from our digest. We've got our item name information there. Release the pricing. And then we release the quantity data we've collected with these digest steps. And now we're going to put everything into ChatGPT. So this is the important step that you're watching for. We have a ChatGPT step here with the event conversation with assistant. Continue. Now I've got this pretty simple message, which seems to be working okay so far. So I've asked it to create a professional but friendly sales proposal cover letter of 200 to 300 words in British English, which will be included on the first page of a proposal document, which includes products and pricing summary. Make sure text is just the content of the letter and doesn't include address details or other extra elements. My company is called Terrific and my name is Tristan. Please use the following details: company name, contact name, deal content. And so for company name, obviously that's pulled in from the earlier step and the contact first name, but then the deal content is, I'm just kind of using a bit of a hack way to do this, but I'm basically just pulling in the list of packages that are in the item name step. In this case, it's three marketing consulting packages. So it's pretty simple. Let's see what it comes up with. I've already created this writing assistant in a previous video. Check out my link for the other AI, my AI playlist. You can check that out. I'm currently using the model GPT-4.11.06 preview, which seems to be working well, but this tends to change. So it's up to you what you want to try and use. I think 4 is much better than 3.5, so I always use 4, but it also uses up more tokens. So, and then I'm skipping these other steps here. We've got the conversation ID. So this is unique, so the conversation doesn't get confused between the assistant. So I've got this deal ID number, so that whenever I'm having a conversation relating to this deal ID, it's always going to be just one area. I'm not going to get confused with other deal IDs or other conversations. And then we can click continue and we can do a test and we can see what's the suggestion from ChatGPT for our cover letter. Okay, and we've got our data from ChatGPT and now we can throw it into the document in PandaDoc. So let's have a look at action. All this is the same as what I had previously set in the last videos. I'll just update that send document back to no. We have all these details here. The client email, actually, should be like this. Let's type in email, contact email, there it is. And then the important part is we've got this cover letter content. So let me show you how I've added this here. So we have in the standard proposal, the template from PandaDoc looks like this. And I've replaced this with a PandaDoc token instead. It's very simple to do. So I'm in the template and essentially delete that text that I just showed you. And you just type in square bracket and then whatever you want to call this and then square bracket like that. And then it creates the token. That's basically it. And then you can go back to the Zap like this and we refresh fields. And then it will appear above the pricing table here, somewhere up here. Here we go, token, cover letter content. And that's where you put your ChatGPT generated content or your AI generated content can just go in here. And then that's gonna just fill up this whole section in the proposal. So let's have a look at it. We just click test step. There we go. And now let's go into PandaDoc here and let's have a look at our documents and we can see the latest document. Just now, let's open up this hot cartel. There we go. So we've got our document with all the same details that we've gone through in the previous videos. And then we have our cover letter here. So we can see here, it probably needs a little bit of work, but it's a starting point. So we've got, dear, I am delighted to present you with a proposal for tailored to elevate hot cartel's brand, etc., etc. So that all auto generates. You may want to create a little bit of a simpler one. You might just want to have one paragraph maybe, or have some custom tokens within your own written paragraph that you keep using, you know, so you just drop in a little bit of color. So you can do something combination. It may not be the best strategy here to write like one long ChatGPT piece just in case it's not quite, you know, doesn't quite sound human enough, and instead just use a bit of ChatGPT interspersed with your own content. But you can see here, this is what it does when you have it all automatically generated. And then we have the rest of our proposal. And then we've got our pricing table down the bottom here with our examples we just did in that simple Zapier run through. And that's it. So let me know if you've given this a shot, if you've tried ChatGPT or any other AI tools, tying it in with Zaps, tying it in with sales proposals. I'd really love to hear about some examples. And otherwise, if this has been useful for you, please like and comment on the video. I'd love to hear your thoughts and look forward to seeing you in the next video. In the meantime, okay, thanks so much for watching. Cheers.